My thing is this, bro. I feel like schools will care about you if they actually hit you up outside of school. Like, after I graduated, I'm
like, people are laughing.
And
then my nothing. Yeah, I'm gonna go. I don't even care if I don't get paid today. I'm just a stupid old guy. That's all.
Oh, ain't no way I can start this.
Yeah, do whatever you
want to
do. I don't care. I'm gonna do it anyway.
Hey, oh, whoa. I had
And people are laughing. Yeah, I'm gonna go. I don't even care if I don't get paid today. I'm just a stupid just come old white lady. That's all.
Oh, ain't no way I can start this.
Yeah, do whatever you want to do. I don't care. I'm gonna do it anyway.
Hey, whoa.
I'm walking right out the door. I won't ever be back.
That's not funny, but come on.
Hey, Jolo, like, bro,
look, listen to this, bro.
That's please. What I'm saying. Like, school look, right now, bro. Like, it's going so, like, it's going so bad right now because, like, kids not taking it serious. The teachers is getting done with it. It's just like.
Bro, Yusuf. If you remember this, RIP my boy Tori Amory.
Yeah, I know you remember this, bro.
We used to have Woods class, bro, and we straight made our teacher cry. If you remember the Woods class from Bernard Middle School, bro, we made dude cry in the class. Might be that in
high school too.
I straight this video, bro, brings back hellas, man. I remember straight doing this to a teacher.
RIP my boy Tori, man.
I should not laugh at that, bro, but that's probably one of my favorite memories, bro. Is when me and Yusuf and Tori Amory, my boy, made this.
We ain't gonna talk about it, but I'll bite myself again.
I seen it, dog. Come on, man. Come on, dog. Wait, go scroll back to whatever dude was gonna say. Deion Sanders. What Deion Sanders?
I don't even know. Hold on.
Cause some of these YouTube shorts, bro.
I had a rule, you probably seen it on video, that if you're late, you ain't playing. Now you gotta understand, if my meeting start at 7 o'clock, they better have butts in seats by 6:45. I'm probably gonna start by 6:53, 6:55. Okay, consistent. My son came after the break that we left, getting back ready to play the championship game, came at 6:55. The whole team was seated, already in place, and he walks in. I said, get out. He didn't play in the championship game because my rules are my rules. And I can't change it just because you my son and you have my blood. My rules are my rules. He understood. Didn't like it, but it is what it is. He came and played back in the Celebration Bowl, but that SWAC championship, he didn't play because he was late. I had a rule, you probably seen that's it on crazy. Video, that if you're late, you ain't playing. Now you gotta understand, if my meeting start at 7 o'clock, I'm probably, they better have butts in seats by 6:40.
Playing your championship
bro,
game.
Bro, coach will bench you, bro, if you late, if you not doing good in school, if you're not doing what you're supposed to do in practice, he'll bench you if you talking back. If you,
and that's my dude,
if you make an assignment.
It doesn't matter.
Bro, and that's what I'm saying. I've seen Arsante get benched because he wasn't doing what he's supposed to do.
It's real.
You know what I'm saying? I've seen.
That looked like Coach Connor. Coach Connor, you see what I look like you. Come on, man.
But, hey, man.
That's wild.
That's why I tell people. People don't be knowing that, hey, I was cold at football. They don't be believing me.
I was a younger, but I was like, always on the courtyard, so I never went to football. Cool.
He won a football.
Oh, such a square yard.
You know what I'm saying? But he knew Oakville was actually nice.
I knew our team was good, though. Shit.
Dude, football world, we was cold.
I ain't go to my first football game until my senior year of high school.
I got posters of myself and shit. You know what I mean? I got posters of myself. I got trophies and all type of shit.
Right, my boy was in there, like swimwear.
Come on, man.
We went to the same high school, by the way. We talking like we ain't telling you. We went to Oakville High School in South County. That's in St. Louis, Missouri. From the Lou. That's crazy though, bro. I think that's wild. My boy said his son ain't playing in the SWAC championship.
No mess.
Told me to park up, she give me the mata. I put the seat back, can't make the block hot. She got a man, so she moving Nikki.
Yeah.
She said this Louis V making her freaky damn.
Yeah.
Watch how I drip when I step
in the Louis V making me freaky.
Nah, bro. Pause, bro.
The Louis V making me freaky. Bro.
Nah, the Louis V make her freaky.
Okay, okay, okay.
Make her freaky.
I respect
you
that.
Her?
Nah, I'm not.
I'm trying to show you.
The Nike Tech making me freaky.
Hey.
Yo, bro.
From the towel.
Bro, selling.
The boogie to
yo, bro, listen, bro, that's not how we get down in the towels, bro. That's not how we get down in the towels. I can only make her freaky.
Okay, go ahead, bro. The Nike Tech making me freaky.
Hey.
Nah. Bro.
Hey. Yo, go ahead. Get through the whole shit. Go ahead.
She got a man, so she moving Nikki.
With the mask on.
She said this Louis V making her freaky. Nah. Damn. Watch how I drip when I step in the pod.
Nah.
Me. That's making me freaky. Let's do it.
Told me to park up. She give me the mata. I put the seat back. Came at the block up.
My first fight wasn't kickboxing. My first fight was actually MMA. I was 18, nice. And I was fighting a 24-year-old security doorman. Being a stupid American, I thought pounds and kilos were the same, because I weighed in at like 82 kilo, he weighed in at 90 kilo, which is an 8-kilo difference, which is almost like 20 pounds. And I was like to my coach, is that a big difference? He's like, no, don't worry about it. I was like, okay. But thinking back, a 20-pound difference, a big difference in fighting, right? But I just kept going, and I just outgassed him, and towards the end, I'm just on top of him, just punched him in the face, right? And now I'm only 18 years old, and I got in there, and I won. I didn't win necessarily through skill, but from there...
If these snacks get discontinued,
Apollo created the.
If these snacks get discontinued, I'ma tear some shit up. We can all disagree on race, religion, politics, all we want, but one universal truth is that nacho cheese Doritos smack hard. Don't take them away. The world has too many problems as it is. Domino's pizza tastes like squirrel meat. But these motherfuckers know how to do a lava cake, I'll give you that. Sometimes you don't gotta be good at what you're supposed to be good at. You just gotta be good at something. Now, Wendy's, come here, listen to me. Y'all done fucked us over once. Y'all took these spicy nuggets back here away from us before. And you brought them back, you playing with our emotions. And we ain't gonna take it a second time. Keep your nose clean.
Apollo Creed is the most important person to every great Rocky movie.
Bro, you're black.
I gotta tell you, these stream snipers are on a whole nother level, man.
Some house I got. You getting from mother?
Boy, man, you're making.
There's a secret attachment for the Vaznev.
NBA scouts love Bronny James for one main reason. Besides the fact that he seems to be getting better and more confident every single month, I think the main thing that is attractive about him as a player right now is how versatile he is and his adaptability to fit into any playstyle. Watch him here, playing off the ball, setting a back screen to get open for a shot. He's comfortable being a catch and shoot guy. Watch him here, create space and ISO himself into a tough jumper. He can go get you a bucket at the end of a shot clock too. We know he's a freak athlete that can play well above the rim and finish through contact and also playmake for others. He seems to always make the unselfish play and the right play. And what's crazy is his defense is considered to be his greatest skill at the moment. NBA scouts love Bronny James for one main reason. Besides the fact that he seems...
Here's the thing, a lot of these rappers, like, before they blew up, they was watching this. You feel what I'm saying?
Chiefs running back Isaiah Pacheco.
Bitch ain't real, nigga.
Who I need that motherfucker? Where the hell you at, man? Pull
up like you don't get it yet, do you, nigga? Hey, man. We got one you, nigga. They told me where you be at. They told me where you be at.
What city you in?
Hey, in the A. Yeah. You know where you be at, but I got you low. We on you. Yeah.
I mean, if y'all see that.
I don't know about that name. Hey. Oh, that's ridiculous. I did so much top spin there. Great shot. Great shot. So good. Okay, the robot's gonna surf. Look at it go. What? See if it can return my surfs. Oh. How's he getting back to serve? Yeah, come on. Let's try again. What?
Somebody control.
Oh. Wow. That's ridiculous. Peanut butter jelly is just crazy.
Like, it's the best.
No, that's not a thing we have in the UK.
No.
No, we have peanut butter and we have jam separate.
Hang on. You gotta try one. Uncrustables are awesome.
Uncrustables, the goats. They actually are quite good. Peanut white butter bread. And jelly is weird though.
You guys have some weird stuff that you guys eat.
We have baked beans.
For breakfast?
Yeah.
It's the weirdest thing to have beans on your plate for breakfast.
Heinz beans go with anything.
But wait, your beans aren't even like flavored. Like our beans are cooked in bacon with like sugar.
Yeah, you just have tin beans.
Oh, I never would have a tin of beans.
Peanut butter jelly is just crazy.
Like, it's the best.
No, that's not a thing we have in the UK.
No.
No.
If you want to completely eliminate vertical recoil in Apex, you need to know this. This is the reason why pro players get so many accusations on using anti-recoil cheat. Of course, there are probably a few players that really do cheat, but the vast majority of top players are abusing this one technique to have zero recoil. This technique works for both mouse and keyboard and controller, so there is no reason why you shouldn't implement it into your own game. So normally in Apex, when you fire a weapon, it kicks up. Now when you move your aim horizontally, the vertical recoil completely disappears. But in reality, that is not how you aim. What you have to do is move in one direction and pull your aim in the opposite direction. You will quickly notice that all the recoil disappears when you use this trick. This is called recoil smoothing and is one of the 12 tips I mentioned in my 12 aiming tips to GoPro video pinned in the comment section down below that you should check.
Come on, bruh.
Motherfucker think they can sit back there, throw the ball to a man, run it fast.
That's the first.
When you get a tattoo of Jimmy Butler's face,
you must drink.
Did you know the moon's made out of metal?
That's probably technically true, right?
They're theorizing that based on when they lifted off from the moon and they shot their rockets off to lift off, they recorded the reverberations or the sound waves when those rockets landed back onto the moon. The frequency in which they received was like something absolutely crazy. If it was a solid rock or whatever the material is, there's no way it would have gave off that frequency. And they think it, like either it's like solid metal or hollow. In the inside and the outside is, anyways.
Basically, the moon is real.
I think the moon is an artificial element floating above the Earth. Did you know the moon's made out of metal?
That's probably, technically true, right?
Someone leaking your address in chat. Why your mods not deleting and banning them?
Hey, listen. Y'all can leak as many addresses.
This is the end of...
Wow, that's a sharpness, that's what you do it. Yeah. Okay.
Gotta
give
me
one.
Yo.
Okay.
Did you want to what? You want to What's the strangest thing a fan has ever asked you to do?
A man in the KKK came up to me and said, you know, Charlie, I usually hate niggas, but ever since that Dave Chappelle show came on, you and Dave Chappelle make me and Bubba love niggas every Wednesday night. And I'm never gonna be.
Nigga said, you and Chappelle make me and Bubba love niggas every Wednesday night.
This happened, man, I'm not making it up. Every Wednesday night.
R.I.P. R.I.P. man, I
A man in the KKK came up to me and said, you know, Charlie.
That is okay.
Whoa! Y'all.
Oh.
Hey man, my genuine video. I find out what
that's cold time.
Having a make you feel real. Hey man, I feel too much. But all right, man, that's gonna do it for this one, man. Hey, this is just a little IRL talk from your boy.
Hey, why not?
This wasn't even planned. We just, he said, hey, man, you should just turn the camera on. I was like, ain't it?
I'm sorry, you gotta turn the camera on, bro. Get going. What is this? What? That's all we gotta do.
This is a little IRL talk, man, from your boy. Push it in, you know, gang. I ain't do the intro, but you already know, man. Intro. We just sitting back, and relaxing. Not too amazing. Just pistol packing and just relaxing, baby. And you already know it's just with my nigga Leak.
Leak,
man.
Man. Go follow it, bro. The White Matrix everywhere. Y'all know
we already know, man. We got something cooking up in the works.
Y'all ain't even see this coming.
Y'all ain't even see this coming. We got some things just cooking up in the works. But stay tuned for everything else, man. You already know, man. You already know. But hit that like and subscribe button. Man. I love all the support that we got been getting. But let's get right, baby. We got to get back on the grind, man. I'm sorry for all the weight and everything like that. Some things happen with some videos and it just holding everything. So, hey, we about to get back to the work. Let's get right.
Yeah. Now you see we going dumb, dumb, dumb. Now you see we going dumb, dumb, dumb. Yeah, one's too many, honey, isn't enough.